Let's look at some algebraic examples. For f of x equals the quantity x squared plus 2x over the quantity x minus 1, answer the following questions. Is the point 2,4 on the graph of f? Well, in order for that point to be on the graph of f, that means when I plug 2 in, it should output 4. So let's see what happens when I substitute 2 in for x. I get f of 2 equals 2 squared plus 2 times 2 all over 2 minus 1. When I simplify that, that gives me 4 plus 4 all over 1, which is 8. So that means that when I input 2 into my function, it outputs 8, not 4. So no, 2,4 is not on the graph. Part B, for x equals 2, what is f of x? Well, we just found out when x is 2, your y value was 8. Or you could write it as when x is 2, f of x is 8, or f of 2 equals 8. Let's look at an example with the same function, but with some different questions. Letter A. If f of x equals 1, what is x? So what this is meaning is to replace f of x with 1 and solve for x. We get 1 equals x squared plus 3x all over the quantity x minus 1. Now to solve this, I'm going to multiply both sides by the denominator x minus 1. By doing that, this will cancel that denominator out on the right-hand side. I'm left with x minus 1 equals x squared plus 3x. Now I see that this is a quadratic. In order to solve a quadratic, get everything onto one side, set it equal to 0, and use either the quadratic formula or solve by factoring. So let's move the x and the minus 1 over to the other side. And I'm left with 0 equals x squared plus 2x plus 1. Now this can be easily factored into x plus 1 times x plus 1. And remember, if you need a review on factoring, there is a link on the first section's video for that. So now looking at this, I can see that this factor will equal 0 when x is negative 1, and that this factor will equal 0 when x is also negative 1. So the answer to this question, if f of x equals 1, what is x, is x equals negative 1. List any zeros of f. What points are these on the graphs of f? So the zeros of f are going to be when the function equals 0. So let's set this whole function equal to 0. Okay, again, I'm going to multiply both sides by x minus 1. And when I do that, 0 times x minus 1 is 0, and I'm left with x squared plus 3x on the right-hand side. So now again, I'll solve this by factoring. I can factor an x out, and I'm left with x plus 3. This means that the function is going to equal 0 when either x is 0 or x plus 3 equals 0, which will happen when x is negative 3. So the zeros of f are negative 3 and 0. And what are these points? Negative 3, 0, and 0, 0. Because again, for zeros of a function, it's when the y value or when the function is set equal to 0. The last thing is to find any y-intercepts of f, or y-intercept if there is one. So the y-intercepts occur when x is 0. So let x equal 0 and solve for y. So let's do that. So we get f of 0 equals 0 squared plus 3 times 0 all over 0 minus 1. That simplifies down to 0 over negative 1, which is just 0. So the y-intercept is the point 0, 0.